Yes, children. So yesterday we studied about capacitance in series and capacitance in parallel, right? So we learned that capacitance in series, the charge Q remains same, and capacitance in parallel, the potential remains same. Capacitance in series is given by 1 upon Cs is equals to 1 upon C1 plus 1 upon C2 and so on. Capacitance in parallel is given by C1 plus C2 plus C3 and so on. Here V remains constant and here the charge Q remains constant. We have also learned the derivations of both of them, right? So on the basis of that, we are going to solve some numericals, right? So yesterday also we have solved some numerical, and we have also learned that how to solve a circuit in which there are 5 resistors connected such that the overall arrangement matches with the Wheatstone bridge arrangement. That also we have learned. So on the basis of that, we are going to solve a question today. So the question says that if C1 is equals to 3 picofarad, C2 is equals to 2 picofarad, calculate the equivalent capacitance of the network between point A and B. This is C1, 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 C2, C2, right? So how are we going to solve? Obviously, again, I'll remind you, we will not touch those points which are, we will not touch those capacitors which are directly connected to the battery. So how we will solve? We will start solving from this end. C1, C2 and C1 will be in series. Whatever charge will flow from here, same charge will enter here. Right? यहां से जो भी चार्ज आ रहा है C1 में, C2 में और C1 में फिर से आ रहा है. सो ये तीनों किसमें हो जाएंगे? सीरीज में हो जाएंगे, राइट? सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी विल फाइंड द कैपेसिटेंस इन सीरीज, राइट? सो वी विल राइट C1 लेफ्ट साइड बिकॉज ऑल आर ईदर C1 और C2. ऑन लेफ्ट साइड C1, C2 एंड C1 आर इन series. So we will calculate 1 upon Cs will be C1 is 3, C2 is 2. Picofarad we will not convert until, yes, picofarad we will not convert until we get the final equivalent capacitance, right? So this will be 1 by, what is C1? 3 plus 1 by 2 plus 1 by 3. So 1 upon Cs will be, so the LCM is 6. 2 plus 3 plus 2, that is 7 by 6. So what is the value of Cs1? Let us name this as Cs1. So Cs1 will be 6 by 7 picofarad. So ye wala part humne solve kar liya. So the answer is 6 by 7. Now the circuit looks like, this. Ye A, ye B, ये पीछे वाला पार्ट हमने सॉल्व कर दिया है. नाउ द सर्किट लुक्स लाइक दिस. दिस इज आंसर 1, दिस इज C1, दिस इज C2, दिस इज अगेन C1. सो दिस आंसर 1 एंड दिस C2 विल नाउ बी इन पैरेलल. नाउ Cs1 एंड C2 आर इन पैरेलल, राइट? सो व्हेन दे आर इन पैरेलल, Cp विल बी 6 बाय 7 plus C2. What is C2? 2. So it comes out to be 20 by 7 picofarad. This is your second answer. That was your first answer. Finally, after solving these two, now the circuit looks like this. Right, children? Circuit is simplified like this. Now these three will be in series. So now 20 by 7 C1 and C1 are in series. So we will solve 1 upon Cs is 20 by 7 ka upon karenge, so it will be 7 by 20 plus 1 by C1, 1 by 3 plus 1 by 3. So solving it comes out to be, after solving you get it as 61 by, yes, 61 by 60. Final answer Cs will be 60 by 61 picofarad. I hope all of you are getting it. Final answer is 60 by 61 picofarad. Any doubts? please check. Any doubts in any step, please ask. And any particular step you haven't understood, please ask. I'll repeat again. यहां से जाने वाला चार्ज इज सेम हियर. सो दीज थ्री आर कनेक्टेड इन सीरीज. वी हैव सॉल्व इट फॉर सीरीज एंड द आंसर इज 6/7. देन द सर्किट लुक्स लाइक दिस. ये तीनों का आंसर इज हियर. दीज टू विल बी इन पैरेलल. नाउ दीज टू पैरेलल वी हैव सॉल्व एंड द आंसर इज 20/7. फाइनली इसको सिंप्लीफाई करने के बाद वी आर गेटिंग दिस टाइप ऑफ सर्किट. Now these three will be in series because whatever charge is entering, charge has only one way. Whenever the charge is only having one way, we get these three in series, and after solving in series, we get final answer as 60/61. Absolutely correct. Right? Similarly, we will proceed to one more numerical. Children, you may have your assessment very soon, so be prepared for the same. Keep revising all the topics, right? So I'll give you this one. 2, 2, 2. Let us name them as A, B, C and D, right? Say A, B, C, D and, okay, let us name this point as A and this point as D. So, calculate the equivalent resistance between A and D. The question says, calculate the equivalent resistance between A and D. Again, we will try to simplify and check ki whether it is a Wheatstone bridge or not. It may be or may not be. So, we will check all of them. Point A is connected to C through 2 ohms. Let us change their values so that it becomes easy. Let us say this is 5. Say this is 4. This is 3. And this is 6. For your convenience. Yes, A is connected to C through 2 ohms. A is connected to C through 2 microfarad. All capacitance are given in microfarad. A is also connected to B through 4. A is also connected to B through 4 microfarad. Other end. D is connected to B through 6. D is connected to B through 6 microfarad. D is also connected to C through 3. D is also connected to C through 3. And B and C are also connected with this. B and C are also connected by 5 microfarad. Right? Now you tell me whether we can apply Wheatstone bridge or not. All capacitance are in microfarad. Yes. Can we apply Wheatstone bridge or not? So what we discussed yesterday? We discuss whenever this upon this ratio is equal to this upon this ratio, we can always apply the Wheatstone bridge. At that time, what we take, key potential at this point and potential at this point is same. Whenever potential between these two points is same means we can ignore the vertical arm. Whatever is attached in the vertical arm, we can ignore this. So, how to solve this? Now, the circuit looks like this. Now you have to solve between A and D. This is 2, this is 3, this is 4, this is 6. Now you can say 2 and 3 are in series. Why series? ये तो हम ignore करें. यहाँ से जो charge जाएगा, यहाँ पे तो जाएगा नहीं क्योंकि दोनों points का potential same है. तो वो वाला charge यहाँ से जाएगा. So 2 and 3 are in series. 1 upon C S 1 is 1 by 2 plus 1 by 3. That is 6. 3 plus 2, that is 5/6. So, what is CS1? 6/5 microfarad. Clear, children? Yes. So, similarly, 4 and 6 are in series. So, we will find 1 upon CS2 is 1/4 plus 1/6. Solving. So this would be 12, 3 plus 2, that is 5 by 12, that is Cs2 is 12 by 5. Right? So now the circuit looks like this. Right? This is the upper one is 6 by 5 and the lower one is 12 by 5. Right? These two are connected in parallel now. So CP would be CS1 and CS2 are in parallel. So CP will be 6 by 5 plus 12 by 5. So CP would be 18 by 5 microfarad. That is your answer. 18 by 5. Yes, Vafia. Correct answer. So this is how we solve. We identify whether the given arrangement could be Wheatstone bridge or not. I hope you understood. We'll solve one more of the same type.